There's something I've always wanted to try. To make something really strong out of weak materials.
Hi-ya!
This is not a strong beam. I'm gonna use super thin plywood and styrofoam to make a beam that can hopefully hold up a load of hundreds of pounds. It's an I-beam. This is the classic I-beam. It's called an I-beam because in cross-section, it looks like an uppercase I. I need some inspiration. I want to see some I-beams. The reason you're going to see these everywhere is it's the most efficient shape we have for making a beam as strong as possible while using as little material as possible. Now imagine this is the top of the I-beam and this is the bottom of the I-beam. When we apply a load to the middle, it bends. And you can see the screws on the top of the beam, they get closer together. The top of the beam is in compression. Now look at the screws on the bottom end of the beam. Those screw heads get further apart. That means the bottom side of the beam is in tension. We want to put all the material where it's needed the most, at the very top and the very bottom of the beam. If I tried to stand on this as a bridge, it would break in half a second. But it's still strong in a couple of other ways. If I were to hang on this, it would support my weight no problem. It's decently strong in tension. Now, wood is especially strong in compression. If I were to hold this upright and stand, if I were able to balance, it would also support my weight, no problem. So what if there was a way we could build a beam that loaded this up in just tension and just compression? It might be able to hold. So I've taken the two pieces of plywood and styrofoam in the middle and built an I-beam out of it so that the plywood can do what it does best. Take compression on the top and take tension on the bottom. Hopefully, it'll hold my weight. I'm really careful when I'm working with weak materials. See, I'm not far off the ground, so I won't hurt myself if the I-beam fails. Also, I'm starting with my feet out at the edges and slowly moving them inward to make sure it can hold me. Not too shabby. I'm probably about 160 pounds right now. Not too bad for a couple pieces of styrofoam and plywood. So what I've done here is built up the same beam, same amount of plywood on the top and the bottom, but I doubled the thickness of the styrofoam in between. The further out the top and the bottom are from center, the more leverage they get to resist that load. That geometry is so valuable that when you double the height, you can get more than a double increase in the strength. I'm using a hydraulic engine hoist and a big stack of 45-pound weights. So remember before, we had the I-beam with the single layer of styrofoam, and that held my weight, which is a little over 150 pounds. We're about to see if this double-sized beam can hold 400 pounds. Ready? Coming down. Nice and slow. Oh yeah, that's holding. So for only a double increase in the height, going from 1 to 2, we got more than double the strength increase, like an I-beam should. Styrofoam and really thin plywood, we made them strong by turning them into an I-beam, the most efficient configuration to build something really strong out of whatever material you have.